Welcome back, dear viewers. I am in conversation with Major D.P. Singh. So, Major D.P., when you woke up in that hospital where you nearly lost your life and reality stuck, you know, as in what had become of this beautiful body of yours, how is that agonizing? I mean, I'm sure you do not want to go that route, but then a little bit of that journey when you woke up and felt everything was gone.
Well, this is again, if I say generic preconceived thought that it must be agonizing. But to tell you, it might be surprising for you, I never felt anything bad.
Okay.
Because, of course, many of my boys I lost during that war. So I also got injured. And injury is a part of game of the armed forces. So what big deal? Yes, I was a little surprised when in that small hospital of Akhnoor, the doctor visited me when I became conscious. And, you know, his statement was that I'm the only one in the ICU that time.
Okay.
A very small hospital. And the doctor visits me and tells me that that lucky you are that I have come on a round because I can see your toe is getting affected by gangrene. And I was thinking that how can he say me lucky I am? I am supposed, it is his job, you are supposed to be taking round.
How did you let the gangrene happen?
But anyway, that's the part of game. It was on third day of my hospitalization there when they found that the gangrene has occurred in the foot. On the right toe of my right leg. They evacuated me further to the Udhampur, Command Hospital, Udhampur. And it's only after reaching in the Udhampur hospital when the bandages were opened of the right leg. And as I could see that there is nothing left, only a shin bone which is visible from on the top and some amount of flesh downside. So, any logical person can make out that tongue to kategi. But the doctor was very kind and Colonel Ashok Kumar retired as a major general later. He was mustering courage by coming on one side of the bed or the other side of the bed and looking and, you know, inspecting the wound very deeply. And of course, you know, I could make out ki ye to jaane wali hai. And some moments later, he shared the news that son, and his exact words were that son, we need to impute your leg, but we'll try to save as much as we can. And I reacted back, sir, I can see there is nothing left. So please go ahead and do the thing.
Oh my God, you said that. So you were so, you knew this was to happen.
Of course, when it is supposed to happen, is there any point crying over it? But that moment, you know, as I mentioned, maybe during the childhood onwards, I was getting shaped up for something like this.
So devastating. Yeah, right. A normal human being would have, I think, broken down, yelled and cried and why me, God, kind
of situation.
Well,
I will not say that I'm an abnormal human being or something risen or something like that. But then, of course, I feel that I am the chosen one who got not only shaped up by seeing some tough life during the childhood, but also by virtue of Almighty's blessing who gave me the positive perspective to look at the life. And today I feel that I am living much, much better life than what I could have lived otherwise had I not got injured. So for me, injuries is the best thing which could have happened in my life. In fact, I jokingly thank Mr. Musharraf, General Musharraf, that had he not made that bomb which was thrown for me, I wouldn't have lived so beautifully.
Tell us a little bit about that moment in 1999 when this incident happened.
So, no heroism, nothing big like what we see in Bollywood and what many more, you know, my contemporaries and my brothers in arm have done in their life. Nothing I could do. I was deployed on that small post, commanding around 30 men under me. And my post was 80 meters away from the enemy post.
Right.
And the LC was running in between. And my post was on a riverbed. So, one thing which I, of course, know that I was a little pain in ass to the enemy because I used to keep fingering them from one side or another. I remember on one corner of my post, I used to mount on the self-help bunker's roof. In front of that, I still had 4.5 feet of wall in front of me. And from there I used to stand and aim their bunkers with a air burst rocket launcher ammunition. So one day while I was doing that, I could see the other soldier from there is firing a rocket launcher and I am also firing, and he had fired by then. And I could see that ammunition is coming towards me, but I had few fraction of seconds to take my action and complete my action. And I did that. They don't have the air burst ammunition, we do have. And my ammunition must have, you know, devastated them. His weapon which was fired, the round had hit right in front of my wall. So I could get the chance of firing and sitting down to save myself from that. So this is the type of, you know, nuisances which I had created among them, and that's the reason perhaps they were looking at a pot shot me only to, you know, hatao isko yahan se. And that is where the lull happened in the war, when they planned perhaps. I was not so mature, hardly put in 1 year of service. With lot of nonsense type of activities which anybody...
And too much of adrenaline in the blood. Kuch karke dikhana, I'd have to do something.
So, you know, but that is what changes the war scenario. If you feel that you can put mind behind the fighting out, it doesn't work out like that. It's only passion and blind passion which makes us win war.
Absolutely.
Maybe because of this only we lose so many young blood who get martyrs every other day. But that's the type, it has to be like this only. So this, you know, mortar bomb was fired upon me after a lull of 48 hours. And it was aiming me only, because, you know, in war zone you can make out that the if an ammunition is fired, it will land behind you or further, you know, in
ahead.
Front of you. But the one which may land next to you, don't come to know the noise of that. You can't make out. So the one first round was fired, landed quite far behind me. The second one landed with some correction next to me only. And it was 1.5 meters away from me.
Oh my God, just 1.5 meters.
Yes, ma'am. But the killing zone of that mortar bomb, as per the teaching, is 8 meter dia.
Oh my God.
So within 8 meter dia, if somebody is there,
they would die.
They would die. But as
on
this
saved,
also,
yeah.
On this also, I joke around that, you know, wo bolte hai na ki every bullet carries somebody's name.
Name on it.
So when they couldn't find the bullet on which my name was written, they had fired a weapon which is like to whomsoever it may concern. And they even wasted that also.
That wasted. Oh,
thanks to my boys, I must mention them. It is because of them today I am alive. My boys picked me up without worrying about their own life. And this is what the best part of
the brotherhood.
Yes.
Of the army. Absolutely, absolutely. My God, I still have goose pimples on me. Stay tuned, viewers, because I'm going to be back very, very shortly, hearing much, much more from such an inspirational war hero. We'll be back very shortly.